Decades ago, a lot of people would retire and they'd receive a pension income from their company. Real easy to know how much money you had coming in every month and how much you got to spend, especially if you also had Social Security coming in as well. But the trend has been to move away from those types of pension plans to funding 401ks and IRAs. So if you have a pile of money in a 401k and an IRA or a brokerage account, how do you know what a sustainable withdrawal rate would be during your retirement and whether you can actually afford to retire at the standard of living that you choose? Well, let's talk about sustainable withdrawal rate. Most financial advisors, I included, think that a 3 to 4% withdrawal rate out of your portfolio is a fairly safe rate, especially if you build a portfolio that has 60% stocks and 40% cash and bonds in the portfolio. Now, assuming you have that, a 3 to 4% withdrawal rate is a pretty good safe rate. So how do you take a look at it? Well, you look at your retirement income needs. From that, you subtract any fixed income that you would get from a pension, from Social Securities, and the number left over is the number you have to look at to determine whether the withdrawal rate would support that number. If it doesn't, now you need to take a look at other options, like working longer, working part-time in retirement, or changing your allocation to be a little more risky, or if the withdrawal rate really does work well, you might want to be less risky with the investments in your portfolio. Other things to consider: how long are you going to live? Obviously, the longer longevity that your family has, the lower the withdrawal rate tends to need to be. Another one is inflation. How will inflation impact the portfolio, and are your investments positioned to help control the ravages of inflation over time? The allocation of stocks for growth is very important in any retirement plan, and you want to make sure you pick that one carefully. And also take a look at the tax results. That is, you're looking at how much income do you get to spend after Uncle Sam gets his bite of the pie, so to speak. So if you're having a hard time with this subject, not quite sure how to deal with it in its entirety, you may want to look up a financial planner or call your financial advisor for some help.